This is a tutorial video for how to get unlimited ammo in any clip in any weapon in Hitman 2. So to start off, I have a weapon here, and I'm going to open the program Cheat Engine. I have the latest version at this time, which is 7.1. I'm going to find the process in the process list, not load any tables, search for the value in the clip, which is 7. And once that search is done, I'm going to have to narrow it down to fewer than 1 million values. So I'm searching for the current value after changing it. And I've narrowed it down to 2. And I'm going to leave it at this because I know that I'm not going to be able to narrow it down any further via this method. Now, only one of these is going to actually change the actual amount of ammo in the clip. And the way I can tell which one it is simply by changing one of them. And we can see that the value was immediately reverted to its previous one. So this is not the one that is actually going to set the value. So I'm going to delete that address and change this one to 10,000 as an example. And now we've got 10,000 bullets in this gun. And so while this is useful, it does take a while. So to save time, such as if we wanted to find the number of darts in this tranquilizer and change that, that'd be difficult because we can't narrow down with only one dart and then one reload. So the way we're going to have to do that is a more generic solution. So this is how you can find the value every time. So we're going to open up Cheat Engine again, find out what accesses that address. We're going to say yes to attaching the debugger. And now we're going to click stop because we've already found the instruction we want. I'm going to add this to the code list and call that read ammo in clip, because that's what the instruction is doing. It's reading the ammo in the clip of your current weapon. So the way you open up this code list in Cheat Engine is with advanced options. What we can do at this point is find out what addresses this code reads from. We can see it's reading currently from the address of the Silver Baller Mark II's clip. But if we selected the tranquilizer, now that is showing up in this list. So I'm going to click stop, double click on this value to bring it into the list here, and I can change that to 10,000. And now we have 10,000 tranquilizer darts. Thankfully, even though these memory addresses, when you restart the level or switch to a different level, won't point to the correct thing anymore, you can always find it using the code list and the find out what addresses this code reads from feature. So I'm going to click OK. I'm going to just delete all the values in this list here, and now we can save a brand new template. So I'm going to call it Hitman 2 Ammo and save that. So now if we close Cheat Engine and start a completely different level, no matter what, we'll still be able to find the memory address of the ammo in any gun and be able to change it and then have fun with having unlimited ammo in any weapon. This is a save I made previously. I'm just going to demonstrate that this truly will work if you switch levels and will be quite easy. Just wait for this to finish loading and open up Cheat Engine. And we're going to select the process, not load that table, but load Hitman 2 Ammo, the one I just made. Read ammo in clip, find out what addresses this code reads from. Yes. And the weapon I have currently has 10,000 in it. So does this one. And so does this one. Because I was messing around earlier and saved the game after I did this. So we can change all these and see that it is now the value we want. And just to demonstrate real quick, Let's just tranquilize everyone in this room. Got him.
What the hell?
Got him. Got him. There we go. So, we've already tranquilized more people than you're ever able to do normally, because the restriction on the amount of darts they give you. But now we have literally 10,000, or in this case, 1337. But it could be whatever we want. You can also freeze the values. But just remember, when you restart the level, these don't do anything. You have to load the table, and then open your code list, find out what addresses the code reads from, select the weapon, and you'll be good to go. Thanks for watching.